Hello everybody, welcome back to High Functioning Gaming. Okay. I wasn't sure if Samus would, you know, link up with Adam again. Usually she doesn't do that when... She doesn't link up with Adam if she's been in the room before. Ow. Ow. Derp. There we go. The space jump. All right, allow Samus to jump repeatedly during a spin jump. Press B at the right time during spin jump to jump again. When used underwater, Samus cannot gain more height over the first jump without the gravity suit. Why is it just... Oh. I assumed with the tiny... with the little tiny ones, it was... yellow for health, green for missiles, just like the large ones. Hey! Uh-oh. Come to think of it, wasn't there an enemy in Metroid Prime that, due to like having like some kind of strong electrical field around it, Samus couldn't damage it? None of her weapons could, in any ways. It's really small. I mean, like, kind of you have to deal with around morph ball tracks. I could probably save, but I'm supposed to head up that way. Get back here, give me that energy! Why does that make a crackling sound like the Geiger counter from Fallout 4? darn it. What the heck is wrong with me? There we go, that's more like it! Yeah, that's right. There's a cold area behind that. Of course. So, hold up. But I need to get that way. Did it just merge with another one? That explains so much! Yeah, I ain't gonna be getting through that. Juice wasn't worth the squeeze that time. That's more like it. Thanks! Yeah, no realistic way I'm gonna be getting through that. But there doesn't seem to be any other way past all that. That's the gravity suit. Helps me stay in the cold, which it probably does, considering the fact that in a lot of Metroid games, at least the 2D ones, it's just the Varia suit, gravity suit, and that's it. I have an idea as to where I might be able to find it. Just trying to work out the quickest way there. Right by me, isn't it? Yeah. Because this enemy's a dick. And of course, it's right on my tail. Okay, seriously, does the Phantom Cloak actually help you hide from this thing or not? Man, it wouldn't even really help me get there anyway. Dagnabbit. Derp. I know exactly where to go with that space jump. Kind of exotic stuff people might put on pizzas in the far future, like where when this game takes place. Probably gonna eat stuff crazy with pineapple. Wait, I don't really have a way to get anywhere else in Gavarin from over here. There. Wait a second. No, wait, that's right. I can't get there because I need the screw attack. Break on through to the other side. Once I get the gravity suit, there probably won't be much of anywhere I can't reach. And some of the other games, like Super Metroid, once you get the gravity suit, you can even go through lava. Like I tried doing earlier. Except successfully and without taking damage. Slip sliding away. Slurp. Come to think, they probably have faster than light travel, so you could probably get a order of pizza from a whole nother planet and still arrive in 30 minutes. Alright, interstellar travel just really isn't all that feasible without, you know, some means of traveling faster than light. Heck, the closest star is Proxima Centauri, and it's 4 light years away. Which means that if you were to travel at the speed of light, it'd take you 4 years to get there. safe. Yeah, this door. What the heck? That was weird. This little drone is kind of reminding me of Zero's head from Borderlands. They remind me of... They look a lot like the head of Zero, that one Vault Hunter from Borderlands 2. Gravity suit, here I come! At least I hope it's the gravity suit. I wonder why it is that in almost every other place that Samus ends up going to, they use elevators for getting from one area to the next, but this place actually uses elevators, shuttles, and teleportals. Maybe the Mocking tribe got bored of using elevators all the time. Yeah. Ha! Hey, you suppose that maybe for Samus, different colors of ex-parasites would have different flavors? Kind of like gummy candy? Okay, so I guess we're going this way. And there's the buzzer. As always, folks, do not stop being awesome, and I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.